Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Dr. John Scala.
Storm chasers captured lightning striking this television tower in St. Louis from numerous thunderstorms early Sunday morning. And here's another one. We've slowed that down for you so you can see the vivid nature of that lightning. Nothing going on at this hour across St. Louis, but boy, is there a line of storms stretching from Sioux Falls, South Dakota, through Omaha, approaching Kansas City at this hour, and then right on down towards Tulsa, Oklahoma. In the last hour, there was a gust of 69 miles per hour in Omaha. As that line moved across, there is also a tornado threat as this line approaches Missouri and central Iowa. Tornado watch is in place for at least the next several hours. But in St. Louis, it is all quiet at this hour. How about further east where we are? Well, there is some scattered shower activity and even a rumble of thunder northwest of State College at this hour. 70 degrees in Lancaster, 72 at Harrisburg International Airport, Thomasville coming in at 68, and Selins Grove is at 67. Now, this is going to be the story as we move through the overnight hours. Scattered showers, maybe a rumble of thunder as an upper-level disturbance approaches from the Midwest, and that will cross the region tonight and through the morning hours on Tuesday. Look for the overnight temperatures dropping down to about 64 as winds go light, may even go calm in some locations, could provide, in fact, some fog tomorrow morning. Look for some shower activity early on in the morning, and then I think we're actually going to improve as we move into the afternoon hours. I think we get a fair amount of sunshine, in fact, but it's going to be feeling a little bit more humid with our temperatures approaching about 84, 85 degrees during the afternoon. And as we move towards the midweek, we are definitely going to feel more in the way of heat and humidity. I'll show you that in just a minute. 79 was all we could muster today, 3 degrees below the long-term average, right on the money for the overnight low. In fact, that low was reached at 8:05 this morning. 0.6 of an inch of rainfall, that came in this morning with a quick hitter about between 8 and 9 o'clock this morning, 0.6 of an inch. As we look across the region, the storm system, in fact, that brought that light rainfall has now moved into the western portion of the Atlantic. Here's the upper-level disturbance tracking across Ohio and now into northwestern and approaching central Pennsylvania. This will cross the region tonight and into the early morning hours for the first half of the day, in fact, on Tuesday, and then move further to the east. High pressure up to the north has kind of been keeping us in a more stable flow regime, 72 degrees at this hour. Back to the west, though, this is where the heat and humidity is, and this is beginning to spread towards us. 75 at this hour in Cincinnati, still a very warm and muggy 82 down in Atlanta. Well, let's see what the predictor model is showing us. Light winds out of the southeast this evening and overnight, going to be generally out of the south with scattered showers and maybe a rumble of thunder. That will be with us in the morning, and then it kind of spreads off towards the east, and I think we begin to clear out later in the day. And looking ahead to Wednesday, here comes the frontal system that is responsible for those severe storms at this hour in Ohio, back towards Iowa, I should say. And this will spread towards us during the day on Wednesday. This is a very hot and humid air mass. If we do not get much cloud cover late on Wednesday, we may hit 90 degrees. Otherwise, it looks like it will be around 88 with scattered thunderstorms coming in there. Thursday as well, still unsettled with that front approaching. It moves through, and we see our temperatures fall back down and certainly more comfortable humidity. Overnight temperatures of 70 by midweek will make it feel sticky.
Sounds stormy.
Yeah, midweek could be a little bit more on the stormy side.
Thank you, John. All right.